Rugby league has hard hits.
So does domestic violence.
Rugby league has penalties.
So does domestic violence.
Domestic violence affects our whole community.
The Tingha Tigers are committed to standing out domestic violence.
Let's tackle domestic violence together. Proudly supported by the New South Wales and Australian governments.
Thank you. Moree Boomerangs side in this reserve track. Brinkster 1, Richard Smith. 2, Jeremy Sampson. 3, Aaron Gordon. 4, Mark Sampson. 5, Brett Finch. 6, Wayne Fagey. 7, Anthony McGrady. 8, Neil Livermore. 9, Warren Sampson. 10, Anthony Robson. 11, Steve Connors. 12, Brett Sampson. 13, Alan McKenzie. 14, Damien Smith. 16, Neville Tolmie. 16, David Green. 17, Paul Robinson.
Come on, come on, come on.
Successful. Moree Boomerangs lead 6 points to 2.
Say something again. Thank you. kick more.
That try for Moree Boomerangs scored by Mark Sampson. The conversion not successful. Moree Boomerangs lead 10 points to 8. There is a car park at the front of red car, PET948. You have your lights on. Registration PET948.
Rugby league has hard hits.
So does domestic violence.
Rugby league has penalties.
So does domestic violence.
Domestic violence affects our whole community.
The Tingha Tigers are committed to standing out domestic violence.
Let's tackle domestic violence together. Proudly supported by the New South Wales and Australian governments.
Good.
Thank you, Linda.
Brendan Anderson, the conversion by Brandon Sherman, successful. Tingha lead 18 points to 16.
Thank you. Thank you. Guys! And you.
I just wanted to thank Tingha for the game.
Thank you. short arm with one win.
Yeah!
of deceased persons.
The Tingha Tigers have signed on for another year of the domestic violence campaign run by the New South Wales government.
Mate, we want to take you through the story now. We've been covering the domestic violence program, the tackling domestic violence program here on the Barefoot Rugby League show now for a number of years. And we're really excited to see the Tingha Tigers have re-signed on for another year, and the Barefoot Rugby League show got out to Tingha to check them out.
Last year with our domestic violence campaign, it went on exceptionally well. The boys embraced it, the club embraced it, and the spectators. And we've got documentary proof through our Inverell Police Patrol, where the Inverell area was number 17 in the state. It's now blown out to a 10-point margin. We're number 27. So those figures do attest to the success of the campaign. Our boys, with our players, they sign our agreement along with the minister. If they breach, we automatically, for a minor breach, 1 week suspension. Anything major, it's 3 weeks. If there's a second offence whatsoever, the whole season, that player has to stand down. But the boys, good credit to them, and the girls with the league tag, they're doing an exceptional job, and we thank the minister for making this available, the domestic violence campaign. This year, very privileged to have the Boomerangs on board. We had a co-launching with our minister, Linda Burney, our local MP, Speaker of the House, Richard Torbay, our mayors. We had a beautiful launch here, and the Boomerangs, Tingha was a very fortunate on the day. We won that match, but it was an exceptional campaign, and we're very, very pleased with the Boomies coming in. We do have 3 workshops during the year. The girls come up from, Dixie comes up from Sydney, along with our ambassador, Nathan Blacklock. He started off here in 2008. Along last year, we had Larry Corowa. But this year, Nathan is our ambassador for the Boomerangs and for the Tigers. Even though he is down in the Hunter District, he regularly comes back, conducts our workshop. But the girls are the main instigators of our workshops. And Dixie does a marvellous job. And talking to our footballers, well, she's exceptional. During the 2009 season, when we took on the domestic violence campaign, we only had around about 58 players registered. This year, I'm very proud to announce that we've got 108 footballers. They've come out of the woodwork everywhere, and I do attribute it to this campaign because the boys are really taking it to heart. They're very enthusiastic about it, and last year it was a good omen. We won the grand final against Guyra, which is a grand final rematch here today. This year, Guyra and Tingha are actually co-leaders by 4 points in the Group 19 competition. So, best of luck. I hope it's a good omen again.
Well done, the Tingha Tigers, for signing up for another year. And the gentleman refers to Dixie Link Gordon throughout quite a bit. And that's Yelene Gordon's mum, who's running the Tackling Domestic Violence program. Good to see they're doing great things. And those young boys, the ambassadors, the rugby league guys as well, former players and current players, still involved in being Tackling Domestic Violence ambassadors. 14 teams to TC now signed up for domestic violence.
It's fantastic. Just goes to show you guys that rugby league can be the catalyst for, you know, educational change, social change, and here we have domestic violence. And, you know, let's face it, you know, it needs to be stamped out completely. And those 14 teams have taken on the job. I think Minister Burney, Minister for Community Services, started off with a small project last year, and it's just grown. It's going like wildfire. Fantastic.
She's a lovely... I had lunch with her yesterday at near Parliament House. She's a great fan of rugby league. She's doing a tremendous job in the community. And she really has... she can see the game as a vehicle for social reform.
Yeah, mate, she's also a good friend of Barefoot's too, I've got to tell you that.
Great to see, you know, the people of the town getting behind it too, you know. And that's the big thing about country footy is having that support from the local community and people that get behind that. It's a great... it's a tribute to the boys that...
You know, I think it's come back from the Normanton Stingers, Scotty, that had a program running up there in the Gulf Country about the domestic violence in their community.
Mate, a bit higher up than that, actually. It was Papua New Guinea. The federal government put a lot of money into Papua New Guinea because the domestic violence is a significant problem in that country. And a lot of the rugby league boys were used to push the idea, you know, you're not a man if you hit a woman.
Mm, absolutely.
Great stuff. I'm glad all your mob out there too. Hopefully you're supporting this campaign if it's in your community. And obviously making sure you're saying no to domestic violence.